Hello everybody and welcome to another Honkai Star Rail video. Today I am reacting to Braxsophone's Sparkle Guide and Build. And the reason for that is because I really respect Braxsophone as a creator. I've been watching him since the moment I discovered him at the start of Honkai Star Rail coming out. Him along with a few people like MTash, Tectone, Gotcha Smack are along with some of the people I discovered along the way, like It's Pokey, that whole group of creators, a few others as well, are what began to inspire me and continue inspiring me every day to continue to make content. So anyway, with all that being said, we're going to react to his guide here because I am planning on pulling for Sparkle tomorrow. I have reacted to a ton of all of her drip marketing that's come out. All of her trailers, all like three of them, and the other video that they put out that kind of, you know, briefly went over her abilities on the Hoyoverse channel. Sorry, on the Honkai Star Rail channel. All of that has made me extremely hyped for Sparkle. Doubled my hype for her already. And so I'm going to learn how to build her now, thanks to Braxsophone, who, by the way, his YouTube will be actually... His YouTube channel will be linked in the description below. So make sure to check him out. Give this video, by the way, a like, of course. And give him a subscribe. And why don't you throw one my way as well?
I don't know if you grew up around theater kids at all, but I did, unfortunately. But I can say with 100% honesty that 69% of them are absolutely insane, and 82.6% of facts you hear on the internet are completely made up. With Sparkle being a premier theater kid, you now have a perfect example of what a red flag looks like. And no, you can't fix her, like your financial security. This character is so unhinged that if she was a door, she would fall over. And easily the worst thing about her is that she had to smell like Sampo for a minute, and now she's decided to live in Bronya's skin.
True. Except
she does her job a little bit better, at least for most characters. Today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to play and build Sparkle, and if you enjoy these videos, make sure to let YouTube know the video doesn't suck by
Alexa, turn the light to warm white.
Okay.
Leaving a like down below. Subscribe if you feel like it, and with all that being said, my name is Braxsophone, and let's talk about Sparkle.
Let's.
In every gacha game, at some point, you're going to get characters that outperform the initial cast of 5 stars. It took almost a year for Bronya to become second best, but it's finally happened. That's the power of a truly insane anime girl. While Bronya has a 100%
True.
Action forward...
I mean, people would definitely argue that Ruan Mei made her second best, but now she's third best, and if you pulled for Ruan Mei and you're pulling for Sparkle, you're going to be hard-pressed to find, you know, more than... a few comps where Bronya is a better choice. In fact, if Sparkle fully power creeps everything about Bronya, then of course Bronya will have nowhere left in the game. For people who have both of them, for people that have both of them, Bronya is still the best character on the standard banner and still one of the best characters in the entire game. Okay, so let's just get that out of the way. Just like Tingyun is still relevant, even though Sparkle, or even though Ruan Mei and Bronya, if you have both of them, Tingyun is still relevant, all right? And even Hanya is still relevant. Asta is still relevant. Harmony characters are amazing in that way.
On her skill with a huge damage bonus for a turn, Sparkle has a skill that gives you 50% action forward with a massive crit damage boost for a turn. This crit bonus is huge and it's high.
24% of Sparkle's crit damage, plus 45% for one turn. Then advances forward their action by 50%. Huh. Okay.
Higher than Bronya's ultimate, and even though it's not a full 100% advance forward, 50% is still really significant, and you can see her pull teammates up pretty dang far in the action sequence. At first glance, Sparkle does just look straight up worse than Bronya because of the action forward thing, but she does a few things better than Bronya. The first is that she gives more overall stat bonuses, the second is that she keeps them up longer, and the third thing is that she enables attack boots on literally almost every character in the game. With one of her major traces, she gets a crit damage buff until the start of the character's following turn, meaning that characters that have have follow-up attacks that are separate from their turn, like Jing Yuan, also can keep the buff.
Lenny is eating real good. I don't know what else to say about it.
But that's not all I was talking about. Because the single best gimmick that Sparkle has is the juice. By nature of this character,
the juice!
She can actually allow you to hold two extra skill points, which allows you to stock up to 7 at a time.
Oh, yeah. I wondered
if she was just a normal character, but fortunately for us, she's clinically insane. When she uses her ultimate, she recovers 4 skill points for the team. And for those of you who don't know, that makes her go +1 skill points over 3 turns, which basically makes her Bronya skill point positive without having to basic attack at all.
Gains 4 skill points right off the bat, just out of nowhere. Press R, gain 4 skill points.
Which honestly is a little bit makes her Bronya, but skill.
That is crazy. It's crazy. Only 110 energy. That is not much. That's like an amount, but like it's not on the high end. High end would be like 130. Where like QQ is, right? 110? That's not bad. That's not bad. That's pretty spammable with a good energy regen rope. That's, you know. And then grants ally Cypher. With allies with Cypher, each stack of the damage boost provided by Sparkle's talent additionally increases by 10% for 2 turns.
Positive. Without having to basic attack at all. Which honestly is a little bit of a bummer because it's the best basic attack of the entire game. Even if you
have
to basic attack due to SP mismanagement, or in other words, skill issue, you'll still get the full 30 energy you would normally get from her skill, because one of her major traces gives 10 more energy per basic attack. Also, her
that is crazy, by the way.
Damage bonus called Cypher for 2 turns, which seems small until you factor in her talent, which also gives a damage bonus for skill points spent between Sparkle's turns. Every skill point you spend gives damage bonus up to 3 stacks and refreshes the turns left on the buff. So
that is exactly like the, well, not the exactly by the numbers, but the propagation buff from Simulated Universe, where every time an ally uses their skill and it's on a damage dealing skill, they gain 20% more damage on their next attack, and it stacks 3 times. So a character like QQ will go, or Don Hong will go, they'll use their skill like 3 times to power up their next attack. And so they'll give themselves 60% of an attack boost, a 60% attack boost before they attack. You know, it's crazy.
It's basically always maxed out unless you just spam basic attacks for a minute. This is actually one of the biggest things that separates Bronya and Sparkle. Since Sparkle can actually gain 1 skill point over 3 turns, whereas Bronya needs her signature light cone and Eidolons just to break even. And even then, it's only a chance to actually break even. Having a character that has true action forward every turn is absolutely insane. Okay, so now you know about the juice. But
the juice!
The sauce. Sparkle's skill uptime is every turn. Her talent is basically full uptime as far as the damage bonus goes, and her ultimate lasts for 2 turns. But what if I...
Oh, Braxsophone. Give me the sauce.
I told you that her ultimate could actually last for 3 turns instead of 2. If you wait until after your DPS's turn has come up, and then use Sparkle's ultimate, your DPS's first turn of Cypher buff won't actually count down, meaning you can always have the damage buff up in a 3-turn Sparkle rotation. That's it. That's all. That's everything.
Sparkle's
kit is incredibly stable, unlike both her mental health and the people who play her. What do I mean by that?
Real.
On top of everything I've said already, her last trace gives your party 15% attack bonus for free. And if you add quantum characters to your team, you get an extra bonus to that attack. So the mono quantum.
Guys! QQ is going to be insane! My QQ is going to be monstrous! Monstrous!
Dream is no longer a dream. It's very real and you should fear for your next paycheck. Overall, 50% action forward is very strong, and you'll see in the footage that a lot of the time it even pulls my character up next anyways. With all of these buffs and them having such crazy uptime, all you have to do is make sure that your Sparkle has a solid build and she can be crazier than your ex. I'm just kidding, Star Rail players don't date. For her talent priority, go ahead and focus on her skill, her ultimate, her talent, and then her funny kick. Sparkle is basically Bronya if I wanted Bronya to break my heart. Having similar kits means similar builds and principles, with the only difference being that Sparkle doesn't actually need specific speed tuning most of the time. Her best set at the moment is 4-piece Messenger for personal speed and a speed buff to your team. If you don't have 4 pieces though, you can also go with 2 pieces of the speed set and any other 2 that give defensive stats like HP, defense, and damage reduction. For planar set,
wow.
All of the content.
Was that Guard of the Wuthering Snow? Holy. Is there a single character that uses that in the game? Is there a single character that is meta on in the game? No. That's why Sparkle is the best character of all time. But still, you should go for the four-piece hackerspace set. But yeah, I mean, yeah.
Like HP, defense, and damage reduction. For planar sets, for basically all of the content in the game, going with Broken Keel is going to be amazing for the team crit damage.
Oh, real. Oh, wow. Okay, that is good for me then. Because I have a lot of those saved up that I locked just because they looked like possibly they'd be good in the future. And obviously nobody used them, or nobody to use them on. And having the effect resist kind of sounds smart, because you don't want your sparkle to be affected by anything, you know? You want her to keep buffing your team.
With a quantum DPS, you can go with Pentacone for damage bonus.
Oh, that is good too! That's true! That also synergizes with her very well. And I also have a bunch of those saved up.
Stitha doesn't really require any specific stats or height or anything. Other sets that work are Sprightly Vonwalk and Fleet of the Ageless.
Wow. I have a decent amount of almost all of these except for maybe Sprightly Vonwalk.
For main stats, you're going to want a crit damage body, speed boots, any orb, and an energy regen rope. The more crit damage you have, the more she buffs your team, so that's an absolute must. Speed boots are also a must-have because the more sparkle goes, the more you can pull up your DPS. There is no downside at all to having a fast sparkle. The orb main stat doesn't really matter. I'd recommend going for a defensive piece like HP or defense, but you mostly just want to prioritize speed, crit damage, and effect res substats. And for the rope, with energy regen, you can get your ultimate every 3 turns. Now, on the topic of speed, she doesn't want to be speed tuned to your DPS. But with that said, she does want to have a very high speed stat. What Sparkle is effectively doing is forcing your DPS forward in the action order, and the faster Sparkle is, the more she advances you forward. Your Sparkle's speed replaces your DPS character's need for speed. You can run attack percent boots on almost every DPS to gain overall damage if Sparkle is on the team, since she can make them act sooner. So what I personally recommend, and what I've tested, is going for 160 speed on Sparkle, focusing most of your effort on speed and crit damage substats. With proper investment, 160 is achievable for free-to-play players, especially if you go with a mixed 2-and-2 setup. If you don't believe me, go to my stream. I saw like a 180 Bronya the other day. My friend who did theory crafting for this told me to put this on screen,
Olé.
So here it is if you want it, but I'm a...
Uh-huh. Wow.
Be honest, I'm doing a Zilla cosplay right now. And just in case you kind of dissociated during all that yapping, me too, here's a build summary. Focus on speed and crit damage, with some emphasis on effect res, so that way she doesn't get topped by Kafka.
Okay. Topped?
Let's keep it real. A lot of you guys probably pulled for Sparkle because she's absolutely busted. But I'm sure a ton of you guys just pulled for her because of her story appearance, or maybe her twin tails. If you pulled her for twin tails, then you're the most valid of the three. Luckily for you, though, she's
everything.
Very free-to-play friendly. Chaotic Evil Hu Tao can use a ton of different light cones, ranging from medium to premium, just like her. Obviously, they're gonna make her signature the best for her. It gives a ton of crit damage, and it also gives allies crit rate and crit damage buffs. The next...
That's what I'm saying! Oh my god. Bronya's light cone makes her regenerate 5 skill points. I don't know how needed that is, but that's funny. Yeah, past and future looks pretty good too. Because you bring them up to speed, and then you make them deal 32% increased damage. Right? Oh, okay. Yeah, Bronya's does that, but just better down here at the end. Yeah, when the wearer uses their skill next ally taking action, deals more damage. Okay. The effect can be triggered every 2 uses on the wearer's ultimate. Okay, yeah.
No, it's for her. It gives out.
Yeah, this is crazy. Where's crit damage by 32%? That's a lot. That's a decent amount of crit damage. The start of the battle, gain mask for 3 turns. When wearer's mask, allies have crit rate increased by 10% and crit damage increased by 28%. For every 1 skill point the wearer recovers, they gain 1 stack of RF. And when the wearer has 4 stacks of RF, all stacks are removed and they gain mask for 4 turns. Wow.
Ton of crit damage, and it also gives allies crit rate and crit damage buffs. The next best thing, though, is either Bronya's signature light cone or past and future, under the assumption that it works most of the time. With Bronya's light cone, you can even get an extra skill point back 1 to 2 times per battle. Planetary Rendezvous is an amazing light cone in mono quantum teams, and I even recommend it above everything else but her signature for that team specifically. But even in just a quantum DPS setup, it's pretty solid.
She has so many possible synergies for a mono quantum team. Like, you put Planetary Rendezvous on her. And then you put the one orb and rope that, you know, give her the boost. Give like the 10% crit damage or whatever it is. Or 10% crit rate, whichever one it is, for people of the same element. That's crazy.
Team specifically, but even in just a quantum DPS setup, it's pretty solid. Snap the Neck, Weave the Clouds, and Dance 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 are fantastic options. And lastly, the Dreamville Adventures light cone is your second free-to-play option, which is the worst of the two. I would definitely craft Past and Future over that one. Funny enough, Meshing Cogs, which is usually one of the top choices for every harmony, is basically useless here, since you're trying to only ever use her skill. I'd recommend Past and Future if you don't have any premium options, just because it is craftable. There's not really damage rankings for these, since it depends on the team, but here's what I recommend.
Wow. Was that middle one? Oh, Monaco. Huh. I'll be using her a lot with Donhung IL, so I'm not going that move, but...
Sparkle's insanely valuable and a huge addition to the HSR roster. Many units can be replaced with Sparkle as a strict upgrade, and that's not an exaggeration at all. She is incredibly powerful. So what does she bring to the table? Racism. The first thing that I want to talk about is going to be the premier mono...
Hey, it makes her better. It makes her stronger. Makes her stronger. We're going to skip the best teams for Sparkle section. Okay. I won't skip it, but I'm not gonna be positive. I feel like it's just scumbag move whenever you're reacting to someone else's video to just skip a part of it.
Quantum team, right. Finally, guys.
We're gonna give it all the watch time because we're putting this on our channel. You know, we're reacting, you know. So let's be respectful here.
100%.
Let's give them all the watch time.
Potential. Although Sparkle doesn't really fit in with the color scheme here, so that is a little awkward. Anyways, of course,
true.
This team is going to be pretty good. You have Zila, who is going to be one of the best quantum DPS. Silverwolf for the single target quantum application and a ton of debuffs on the enemy. Sparkle to buff your Zila and give you unlimited skill points, so that way you can use Silverwolf and Zila together. And Fushron, who's going to help you mitigate a bunch of damage, give a bunch of crit rate to everyone. And overall, this team actually functions incredibly well. Now, one other thing you can do is you can actually go and pick her.
There you go.
However you say her name. This is one of the only teams that has a bunch of RNG in it that you can literally just mitigate by playing 4 quantum characters. This team, you're actually getting a ton of extra skill points, which this gambling gremlin girl can actually use to maximize her damage. On top of that, like I said,
this mono quantum, the possibility of a mono quantum team might actually make me pull Silverwolf. Because I have Fushuan, I have QQ, she's really strong. My QQ is probably a top, probably second best damage dealer on my account now that I have Donhung IL, and he is performing very, very well. And I have his light cone. And then we have Sparkle, which we are pulling, and we will get, of course, obviously, you know. And then also Silverwolf to make sure that the quantum element goes on everybody. I think this might make me pull Silverwolf on her next rerun. It might. Just the possibility of being able to do this mono quantum team would be awesome.
The extra skill points help with Silverwolf a lot because whenever
I like mono teams. I like Mono Imaginary too, although we don't have it yet because, well, we do, assuming that you use Yukong, I guess. You can use Yukong as your Harmony character, but I'm really hoping for a 5-star Imaginary Harmony at some point here. We're also, I mean, Imaginary Harmony is going to be what the next is said to be, what the next main character thing is as well. So we're getting that for free, and that's going to be guaranteed E6 just by playing through the story. The problem with that, though, is that usually the main character, the main character forms are usually in, within like the power scale of a 4-star. We haven't really had any, I mean, the physical Trailblazer or the Fire Trailblazer, neither of them, the Preservation or Destruction, have even almost touched the power level of the other ones. Which, honestly, I feel like they should change that, in my opinion. Not go back and buff the other ones, but maybe just whenever they come out now, they should probably be maybe be in the power of a 5-star. Or at least a 4.5, you know, better than most 4-stars, but a little worse than most 5-stars, I would say. I think that'd be a good balance, because the thing is, by the time you get to Pentakony, and you've done all the quests before that, right, your Trailblaze level is going to be higher. You're going to be playing the game for a while at that point. Yeah, plus it's just nice, you know? I think just people would just like that in general, and it would actually give people a reason to use the main character in actual content, because I think that's what they want, right? That should be what they want. It's the main character. You should want to use the main character, it feels like, right? But I don't know, maybe that's just me.
Whenever you run into an enemy that you have to apply quantum to, she can do that with the use of one skill, so you're not going to have to deal with the RNG of multiple different elements. So yeah, Mono Quantum is finally here. It's a pretty solid team. I'm not going to call it the best team, but it definitely is a very easy one to get through most of the game with. But one of the ones that everyone has been asking me about over at twitch.tv/braxsophone, make sure to go follow if you want to see lots of Honkai Star Rail content done live, is Don Hung, because he obviously eats a shit ton of skill points. Well, Sparkle does make his job a little bit easier. He can dish out a lot more enhanced basic attacks due to her giving extra skill points on occasion. We've already figured out ways to circumvent his skill point needs because we already have teams where we run our supports very, very fast. For example, a fast Ting Yun and a fast Locha are only going to benefit Don Hung. And now that we have someone else to add more skill points, he has become essentially a Black Flash more powerful. I highly recommend pairing Sparkle with Ting Yun in general.
Oh, yeah.
Because Sparkle doesn't have a ton of attack buffs unless you're playing Mono Quantum. And while there are a lot of characters that are oversaturated with attack, normally in some places where you would run Bronya, you can now run Sparkle, who doesn't actually give as much attack as Bronya does, so Ting Yun can compensate for that and also be another SP positive force. And the next team I want to show you guys is probably my favorite gimmick team of all time, actually. It's really funny. This is called Unlimited Blade Works. Yeah, I'm not fucking kidding.
I am the bone of my soul.
Why is it called Unlimited Blade Works? Because you have two people constantly forcing Blade forward. Poor Blade is going to be overworked.
That? I will do that. I will do that. Honestly, I hadn't even thought about that because the move forward. That is insane. That is awesome. I am 100% gonna do that. Sparkle, go! Give Blade a crit damage boost and speed up his turn. Okay, now Bronya, go! Make Blade go next and speed up his turn. Wait, yeah, make Blade go next and give him a crit damage boost again. Back to back to back, this guy... This guy's like 1,000,000% crit damage, and he's going 17 times per turn. It's going to be crazy. I'm 100% going to do that, by the way. And the more times he's going, the more often he's proccing his follow-up attack, his ultimate, of course, and he's just going to keep going. I mean, Blade is a monster. The more turns you give Blade, the slamming will come down upon them. Right, and I honestly think that a Sparkle Bronya combo is probably good with any hyper carry character in the game, right? Because whenever you think about it, right, as long as Sparkle's using her ult enough, it would have to be tested for sure, but as long as she's using her ult enough, You should be able to also kind of give Don Hong IL a ton of turns too, right? Maybe that's a little bit too over-exaggerated, but assuming he's going often and he's using his alt, which is giving him 2 points towards his alt, towards his, you know, 2 skills towards his next attack. So then next time he attacks after using his alt and he only needs to use 1 skill point, things like that, you just keep it going. This guy just keeps having turns. I've played him with the hunt path in Simulated Universe, right? And I've had a bunch of things where, you know, because I'm playing hunt in the late stages, he just goes like 3 times per turn and he still makes it work. He still uses his max empowered attack every time. He's using his alt at least once or twice a turn. It's crazy, right? He just keeps going. I think it could be possible, but, you know, we're going to have to find that out. Actually, I am glad that I watched the section of the video because that is a good idea. I 100% believe I would have arrived at that conclusion on my own because I've wanted to do something like that a lot. But I hadn't quite thought of that yet, you know? I feel like once I had it in my hands and Sparkle was up there, I would have thought about it 100%. But this made me, you know, this expedited the process. And now I'm like, okay, now that's one of the biggest things I want to try.
That's a good thing. I don't know. Basically, what you do is you build a slow blade with lots of HP, decent crit stats, and you get ready to go pound some enemies. What you're going to want to do is speed tune Sparkle and Bronya close together. And realistically, if you want to speed tune these two together to make this strat work, you want to have one character at 156, Bronya being the lower one, and then Hanabi 1 or 2 speed faster. And effectively, what you're going to be able to do is exactly what's shown in this clip where Blade's going to attack. Then you're going to rotate between Sparkle and Bronya in order to bring Blade back to the front of the queue to attack again and again. Again and again. It's really funny and it's kind of insane how well it works. Like, I genuinely have had so much fun with this and I can't wait to see what we can do with more characters. The other reason this works is because Blade is a pretty SP, not super negative character. So even though these two are going to be eating a lot of your skill points, as long as you have another support that barely ever uses them, just like Lulcha, who spam basic attack, and you have Sparkle as well, who's able to generate all that extra SP, you'll be fine. I've also found a little bit of success with Jingnu in place of Blade, but it's a little bit less consistent. The best luck I've had with this is using multiplication on Lulcha to bring his action forward consistently and get him more attacks overall, which will lead to him getting more skill points. And lastly, I just wanted to show you some of the DPS that she really excels with. Obviously, I already talked about this person on the left, and I actually just talked about Jingyue too, which was not in the original plan, so I kind of went off script for that one. But I do want to talk about Jingyue. And one thing about Sparkle and Jingyue is that it actually works a little bit differently from Bronya and Jingyue. People say not to use Bronya with Jingyue because if you use Bronya, you're not going to actually be able to get her buff on your Lightning Lord. But with Sparkle, she has a trace that helps you fix exactly that. Her trace makes it so that her skill crit damage bonus that she gives lasts until the start of the target's next turn, as opposed to going away at the...
Oh my god. Jingyuan is so back. Right? So Bronya was always the best Harmony character to use with Jingyuan, in my opinion, still. Because she would bring his action forward an extra once or twice per turn, right? Depending on how fast she is for you. And she would bring, you know, a character up, like she would bring Jingyuan up, and then he would be able to use his skill. And then guaranteed that when the Lightning Lord attacks, he has like max stacks. The only problem with it is, just like Braxsophone said, is that the actual like buff to the damage would wear off after, you know, Jingyuan took that turn and used his skill, right? So yeah, Bronya made sure that he always gets his Lightning Lord to max stacks no matter what his speed is, because of her her bringing him up to the front of the queue and getting him to use his skill multiple more times per turn than he would normally get to otherwise. But he wouldn't get the damage boost. And what Braxsophone is saying right now is that Sparkle will do the same thing that Bronya did for him, except he will actually be able to keep a damage buff on him when the Lightning Lord attacks. And that is massive, because that thing slaps. Yeah, Jingyuan is so back. He's so back. And you know what? I'm very happy that I pulled for him when I did. You know what? And I'm happy I have his light code. I'm going to say it. I like Jingyuan. I like having his light code, too. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's right.
End of their turn. This means that Virginia and any character that has some sort of follow-up mechanic where they would lose their buff with Bronya will not actually lose it unless they move again before the mechanic actually happens. The Lightning Lord can receive the buffs from Sparkle. This makes Sparkle and Jingyuan a really solid combo, and if you're not playing pure fiction where you're just running a ton of DPS, Sparkle and Jingyuan can really excel. The only places I would be hesitant to play Sparkle in would be dot teams. Dot teams have been shown to be better with there's multiple DPS or running a character that can buff multiple DPS at the same time, like Asta or Ruan Mei. Sparkle and Tingyuan and Sparkle and Pela are some of my favorite combos, and on occasion, if you get really lucky and there's a skill point positive or just not very negative DPS, you'll be able to use Sparkle and Bronya together with them, and that'll be fantastic. Overall, I'm super happy with how this character works in a bunch of different teams. She's super flexible and one of the best characters they have ever released.
Oh, yeah.
The merger of Hu Tao and Yoimiya on the chaotic evil side of things really is going to be a game changer, especially if you were
to
begin with and never got lucky enough to actually get her. Anyways, let me tell you why you shouldn't spend money.
Oh, why you shouldn't. You're gonna say, man. Really? You're gonna make me not only go for her, not only possibly go for her light cone if I get her a little early, and if I win the 50-50. Right? Within the realm of being, you know, still being possible to pull Acheron. But then you're also gonna turn around and tell me, get her Eidolons? Come on, man. I don't think I can be convinced to get her Eidolons. I don't think I can be convinced. I would rather go for a character signature light cone 100 times over than getting a character's Eidolon. Most of the time. I feel like most of the time the light cone is a lot more valuable overall.
Acheron is coming out.
At least in terms of like improving what they do and making them better. Plus, even if you didn't own the character and you wanted to pull for a signature light cone, you could put it on other characters that it works well on. Like Jingyuan's works really good. It's pretty much still the best erudition light cone in the game, unironically, right? So unless you're Argenti using Argenti's light cone, then Jingyuan is the best light cone for QQ. Jingyuan's light cone is still the best one for Himiko, at least I believe.
Pretty soon.
Probably the best for Serval too. I'm not 100% sure, but probably.
You probably don't plan on pulling for Sparkle Eidolons, and that's okay, me too. But I'm contractually obligated to go over to them, so here they are. Sparkle's E1 is an ultimate extension and an attack buff in her ultimate. Honestly, her ultimate extension is only useful in a couple of scenarios, just due to that snapshot thing I mentioned earlier in the video, unless they change that in a future patch like they did with Lolcha. The attack buff is really strong though, and it gives her even more utility to share with your team. E2, however, is insanely strong because it's going to essentially give you 24% defense ignore all of the time, as long as you maintain stacks of her talent. So basically, if you are breathing, 24% defense ignore. If you're gonna swipe a little bit, that is the lucky dolphin stopping point. E3 is a skill and basic level up, and E4 makes Sparkle gain an extra skill point on her ultimate and increases the skill point cap. Essentially, this makes Sparkle plus 2 SP over 3 turns instead of plus 1, and takes away almost all of the need for SP management with the exception of a certain goblin. E5 is an ult and talent level up, and E6 is a massive increase to the amount of crit damage buff that Sparkle gives from her skill. Her skill also shares crit damage with the whole team now as long as her ult effect is up, which because of E1 will be 100% uptime. That crit damage buff is absurd and...
So, alright Braxsophone. Alright Brax. Alright. So basically, what I am to believe here if I look at this, is that it looks like Sparkle is far and away Just baseline, just looking at what it does. Far and away, the absolute number one best character in the game to wail on. Because every single one of those Eidolons, besides the ones that were like talent level ups and things like that, which like is whatever. It's, you know, it's just higher numbers, but you know, the ones that we usually really talk about, the juicers, 1, 2, 4, and 6, right? Those look like the best Eidolons for any character in the entire game. What character's Eidolons are that good? What other character's Eidolons are even anywhere near that good? Like, there isn't any, is the thing. There's not any. That is insane. Maybe there is. Maybe there is. Maybe. Maybe someone will prove me wrong. Maybe someone will tell me, hey, idiot, in the comments. Someone will say, hey, idiot, you forgot about Fushuan. Her Eidolons are crazy. And I'll be like, yeah. Yeah, true. I said I could be wrong. I said I could be wrong. But I'm just talking, like, off the top of my head, raw dog me looking at the screen right now, reading those Eidolons. Those are insane. So, hey, if you've got a fat wallet, throw it at Sparkle.
Makes her a lot stronger for double DPS.
I would say that is a good idea.
Realistically, Sparkle's a lot stronger for double DPS comps at the low.
Not a lot. That's not a lot of money. $3,900 to $5,800. That's not even a lot. When you think about it, that's not even a lot.
Low price of a kidney.
Yeah, we're good.
Sparkle's Eidolons can usually do more for your DPS than their own Eidolons will. And if you're only going for one extra Sparkle or her Light Cone, technically speaking, on paper, E1 is going to be a better game. Specifically, if you have good relics already. However, I wouldn't bowl for Sparkle Eidolons, especially if you're like me and in horrendous amounts of debt. But if you do want to go above and beyond for the Twin Tails, I recommend going with her Light Cone because it gives a ton of crit value to your team with basically 100% uptime. And those crit buffs are going to massively compensate.
See, that's what I'm talking about. I believe in most cases, the signature light cone for characters is overall more valuable than almost every other character's E1. So if you're like, oh, should I pull for another sparkle? Say no and say, I'll pull for the light cone instead, right? Like 99% of people, that's probably, that's the better bang for your buck, right? Or if you're like me and you're like, I want sparkle, and I want all of her Eidolons, and I want her Light Cone, and then I also want Acheron. Problem. I'm broke. Oh well.
Say for your
oh well.
Dog shit relics.
Like and subscribe!
True. True. Like and subscribe. Please like and subscribe to Braxsophone here. His channel will be linked below in the description of this video. Just wanted to copy it already, just so I can put it there in the description whenever I upload this bad boy. So, thank you all for watching. If you like the video, like it. Please subscribe. Stick around for a little bit. Check out some of my other videos. Maybe you'll like those too. I've been really going hard on the Sparkle content. It's mostly because I just want to watch these trailers on cam, and they put out 4 of them. Like, I'm not trying to make, like, 10 different Sparkle videos, right? I'm not trying to. But she is probably one of, maybe, like, top 3 of my favorite characters to come to the game now, at this point. And I don't even have her in my hands yet on my account, right? It could go up more, right? I don't think she's going to beat out Blade, how I feel about Blade. But definitely, in my opinion, one of the coolest characters in the entire game. They've done so much drip marketing for her. I've done all the reacting for that. You should check that out. I'm going to be streaming my polls, right? For this character. I'm going to be streaming my polls and recording them to upload as well. And I appreciate everybody, all of you, who've decided to watch this video, especially to the end, 39 minutes in. Yeah. Peace.